Yeah. Thank you. Thank you so much for being here. Please give yourselves a round of applause. Today is very important for me, especially, for many reasons. One, to be on this stage, same stage that saw people like Byron Kawadwa, like Robert Serumaga, and all those great, great, great names and artists. For me, this is very important because I see myself as a real artist. And that is why I insisted to be here. I am, of course, a little nervous, but I'm going to try as much as possible to just be myself so that you enjoy who I am truly from the bottom of my heart. Yeah. Now, I'll be talking about each individual song a little bit so you understand where I come from. But first I must introduce what it is about. It is about my guitar and I. And I'll introduce this guitar to you. I call her Jojo. Jojo is my mother's pet name. And I didn't buy this guitar. It was bought for me by a friend in the US. He's called Julius Juko, with whom we started long, long, long time ago. And he did that because he couldn't be here to, you know, help me send my mother off. That is why she's called Jojo. And I am officially Henry Benjamin Serwanja Lwanga, but I didn't want to be called Junior, so instead of being Henry, I accepted Harry from both my parents. The second, in deference to my father, great man he was. And then the lungfish man, Kubandi Musajja wa Mamba. And of course, Lwanga, because that is my last name, that is my blood, that is my family, and I am proud of that. Now, what has been happening is I've been talking. And words, what about words? Words are the things that can make you, can break you, make you laugh, make you cry. Words are the things by which we understand each other. Words are things by which we express ourselves. This little, I don't know if I should call it a song, it's an instrumental. The reason I called it words was because I played it for such a long time and it didn't have words in it. And I was thinking, I should put words to this song. There was no words coming to my mind. So I said, okay, if you don't want me to put words into you, I'll call you words, yeah? So let's just listen and see. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. If you notice, I just went into the twangs a bit, which I was supposed to actually play as a second song, because I feel grateful to so many people. First of all, to all of you for being here. I am really grateful. This is the first ever time. Thank you. This is the first ever in the 30-some years that I've played music that I'm not playing in a bar. That I'm telling you the truth. That I'm sitting here on this very important stage. And I am overwhelmed. I like to thank some people especially. I don't know if Ivy is here. Ivy, I thank you very much. My family, all of you, without regard, I won't name names because then that. I also want to thank the Serumaga Center, because Mr. Robert Serumaga made it possible for me to be here tonight. And I want to thank him. Obviously, Ainzo Kugamanti, Katoyogira Ruzungu, you know, but that's my brother and I know him, so. But I am very, very grateful for that. I also thank National Theatre because times have changed from when we came here as young men with the jam session and the Musicians Club 89. Things have changed, but I never thought I'd sit here, but here I am right now. So nation chevaliza mukama, you know, I'm truly grateful. I'd like to thank my sister, Mkuru Wange, Linda, because you're there for me when I'm down and out. And I also want to thank all my children. Every one of you, Natasha, Solomon, Binta, Tamara, Benny, Sheila, all of you, because I'm not an easy man to deal with, and I'm telling the public now because I am an artist. An artist is not a very easy man to deal with. Yes, yes, my sister, I heard your voice. an artist is not an easy man to deal with. We are very, very emotional, and our moods swing to and fro, and we tend to see things differently. And it's only people who love you that will agree with you all the time. Even when they disagree with you, they agree with you. So that's the next small song I want to do is one that I got from a man I admire so much. Mkuru Wange. Well, before I say that, I must, without fail, thank Mr. Moses Matovu. I call him Master. Please give him a big round of applause. He made the sound possible, and I hope the sound is good with you. And Moses has been there with me from day one. I'll tell you as we go along, yeah? And then I want to thank Mr. James Owaraga. You know what James is doing there? We were in school together. He's my young brother. But when he learned about this, he said, you know what, we want to stream it live. I said, wow. I didn't, because I'll be honest with you, it's very hard to put up this when you don't have money. But now I have cameras with me. You know, I have the works. And I am truly grateful. James, thank you very much. And his team, really, who are people I know from a long time within the industry. I really am grateful. Yes, and this is Raymond here. You know him from TVs. You'll see him when the light goes on. Okay, the next one is something that really comes from the heart of Buganda. It's a folk thing. But when I first heard Mr. Samite Mulondo do this song, I said, wow, I wish I could do it. On the day I was moving from home after Mummy went and I was going to Chari Wajala, to another home, to Namugongo, I just started to mess around with this little thing, and I found that I could play it on guitar. I can't sing it, but I can play it. So I'm going to try and reproduce it the best way I can right now, yeah. Thank you. Thank you very much. While I was playing this, I was thinking about Mr. Sammy Temorondo, and he's such a wonderful artist because he takes music from home, from our roots, and presents it like it's for today. And that's something that is important, that we must go back and revisit. That's what makes us different. Makes it hard though, but that's what makes us really different. And that is why sometimes our journeys are very, very hard. But our journeys are not that hard because we have you. We have you who believe in us. And the next song, which is really my first song, is one I wrote for a wonderful woman. Wonderful woman. When I wrote it, it was for her. But as I wrote it, I thought, no, it's going to be unfair if I just wrote it for her because there are many like her in my family. And I've not seen her in many, 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 many years. I believe she's here. Auntie Mire, I think you represent for us as a family, every one of us, with all our different moods and, you know, but we are one. We always will be. It doesn't matter what happens, yeah? So that is why I wrote it in such a way that it will be meaningful to everyone that is in my family. Every one of you, this song is for you.
For you,
bana bangi. For you I'll do anything for you. For you. Yeah. The next one is sometimes sad, but don't worry, we'll come to the others as well. Once I was playing at the Serena, and there's this, I don't mean to sound racist, but this old white man came and said, "Why is all your music so sad?" And I told him, you know, it's a sad world. It is a sad world, really. Anyhow, that is the pain and the beauty of being an artist, that you see things and you want to express them the way you see them. If you want to be a real artist, you won't be trying to be somebody else. I was going to mention a name, but Anyhow, this song was a tribute I wrote for Jojo, from whom this guitar got. It was the first thing that came to me one morning. I was dreaming about, and this is what came to me. And somehow, that's how I write my music. Something comes to me just like that, and I write it 2 minutes, 10 minutes, it's done. And the way I wrote it is the way I recorded it. I even put it on the internet at Reverb Nation, just the way it is. I didn't really think about the quality or whatever. That didn't matter. It's the message for me that really matters. Thank you. Thank you very much. I want you to notice how a song like that is written. You know, you say Nenyiga, Nenkaba, Nensanyuka, Nenyimba. For someone who doesn't really think about things. I say, Ateno Nyiga, Ateno Sanyuka. You know, I write my songs in a way that, you know, you may need to think about them a bit. I intend at some point to ask you to ask me a question or two about how I write my music, because this is how I want this to be. It's my guitar and I. And I want you to know who I am, where I'm from, why I am the way I am. And you may spread the word, yeah? Okay, the next song I wrote when my son was a very little boy, about 3 years old. And his mom, whose mother had, you know, sort of disappeared without trace, she upped and left. And this very beautiful girl would sit, you know, she'd be sad and sad. And that is what inspired this song. Like so many other songs, I had an old guitar that Alex Mukuru had thrown away and somebody had picked up, so I picked it from that person when they were leaving the country. And that guitar, one of my sons, Binta, has a history. And that guitar taught me what I know now. So the song is called Musango Gwani. And these are things, they have no answers. And I hope I'll do it justice tonight. So much way, if you know, so be we muza in sin, Jacutuara, but moyo. Okumarugo Biwaya galanga Rwabatwala Musango Gwanyoko Tobi Tegera Tunula mu moyo go okumarugo biwaya galanga byakuitako musango gwanyogo sibitegera. Thank you. ebizibu byetulaba byebikuza omwoyo lugendo tulamaga entuuko y'emu ogwona gw'omusango sibitegeera ogwona gw'omusango sigutegeera Yeah. If you notice, some of you may not remember, there's something that I attribute in that song to Katoru Wama, my old friend from way, way back. And in those days, we used to have that, Aban Shebagama, Sibitegera. You know, it was the word in those days. That's how old this song is. I recorded it on the album Homemade, Breaking Silence, which I did with Fat Boy, James Onen, in his Jade studio with Dennis Asimwe and Gordon Begumisa, and a whole lot. That album I never really released, but I will revisit it because it has some really nice songs. The next song is one of my hardest to play and sing. I've done a second recording recently, which will be on the album that I am working on. It's called Ubuntu. But I first recorded this song with the great late Tony Sengo. Great, great, great artist. But in that recording, I couldn't sing, and I know it. I knew it. So Nenkora, what in music we call name flatting, because I went off, did flats where I should have done other things. I still find that problem going into it, but it is a great song in my opinion, and when you listen to the recording you will understand why. But I'll give it a shot tonight. Yeah. Jagarambe ngechinyonyi Jagarambe ngechinyonyi Tumire iyo mubwengula ngechinyonyi Tumire iyo mubwengula ngechinyonyi Ebintu byakunonze binnemye kuyagaliza ebirungi yakubba akutwale ekirooto kyasiima Osula bulindalo kesantisa Nze kyenva nyiga, kyenva nkaba Leka n'ennyumba Kyenva nyiga, kyenva nkaba Leka n'ennyumba Njagala mbe ng'ekinyonyi Jagarambe ngechinyonyi Tumire Mubwengula ngechinyonyi
tuwa kuno zemune mie Oya galizo urunji agea Otute chiro utochasima Osura urinda loke santisa Zechembanyiga, chembankaba Lekane nyomba Chembanyiga, chembankaba Lekane nyomba Jagalambe ngechinyonyi Jagalambe ngechinyonyi Tumire owengula ngechinyonyi Tumire Ngechinyonyi Ebintu byako nonze binnebye Mbeera zaako nonze zinnebye Bantu baako nonze munnebye
Thank you. Thank you very much. That song reminds me, there's a young lady that I used to work with. She's called Sharon Naruoga. She now lives in Australia. And she told me she was coming back to get, you know, she's bringing her husband home at the end of this year. And I just remembered that she sang the song very well, so I made do a version with her. I just wanted to mention, just for. All right, there are times in life when you're down and out and you feel that there's no love in you anymore. This happens to us a lot. When I say us, I mean us artists, you know. There are people who think they are artists and they are not. I am telling you the truth. Okay, this is one song whose genesis I will not go deep into. But those of you who have heard it and know me know where it comes from. And yet still, even as I wrote it in that moment, I thought back of where I come from. So you will feel a bit of some of the our own folk songs, yeah? Mukwano gwange ugenze Mukwano gwange ugenze Mukwano gwange ugenze Mukwano gwange ugenze Badde nawe Gombe mirembe Non jagaza bantu Nabata galika Omutima gwange No gujuza dana Go gujuza, no gujuza
mujiza nekujulira ddala Omukwano gwange ogenze Omukwano gwange ogenze Mukwano gwange ogenze ndabira bali ekeyo Ondese bw'omunti ali njagala nga ggwe Muluuta na buloosi gagujjuza Nagujjuza, nagujjuliza ddala Gagujjuza, nagujjuza, negujjulira ddala Nayagala ntya ng'ogenze bananjagala batya nga toliwo Nayagala nga ntya bananjagaza nga ki Omukwano gwange ogenze Omukwano gwange ogenze Omukwano gwange ogenze Omukwano gwange ogenze
Thank you. I suspect you will feel a bit of the Eli Wamala influence in that. I did work with Mr. Eli Wamala for some time. His son, James Mwanga, taught me to play the bass guitar, and therefore you will find a bit of that in my message, in the way I present it. The next song, I don't know if my brother Yosia is here. Sadly, because he said he'd be. He loves this song. Okay. Nice one. When I wrote this song, the lady I was living with told me, something like that. But I like to talk about things that I think about. I may not say them in public, but I write a lot of poetry, and this next song speaks about my own personal fear of death, I think, and the way I try to fight it. But it's an old song that I wrote many, many years ago, 16 plus years ago. And it also comes from a folk song, really. So, and Yosia told me that, okay, yeah, my uncle Taka also loves it. Forgive me, ladies and gentlemen, if I talk about my family, but they are my family, yeah? Yeah. Oh, yes, I recognize that voice. Zemmanyi ntekiseera kirituuka nga sikyakuba kidongo nga ne gye mbeera eyo Nju yange y'omu ndibanga naani mu nzikiza etatiisa nkuba ne bwetonnya nkunta nga mbuyaga sikyali muntu ettaka lino
kandi inyendi gumiza kandi sambe ne yagala divani atenze atali riebika itakalino kandi inyendi gumiza kandi sambe ne yagala divani atenze atali riebika uli muntu etisera chituka ngato chakuba ngato ngane jobereyo nyumba yonu olivanga mumu muziki zetatisa nkuba netonya okuntanga mbuyaga totali muntu etakalino kandiri nye ndigumiza kandi sambe ne yagala divani atenze atali riebika itakalino kandiri nye ndigumiza kandi sambe ne yagala divani atenze atali riebika itakalino kandi sambe ne yagala divani atenze atali riebika.
Thank you. When I recorded this song, yes, I've recorded the one that I just did several times, but I did a new version that's going to be on the album Ubuntu. The next song I recorded when I was living in the ghettos of Kansanga. Yes. Yeah, just off Kansas, you know. And in this recording, this song is on the album Homemade, in which all the songs I wrote recorded at home. There were some young ladies, they're here tonight, and they sang to this song. I knew they would say no if I asked them to come here, so I will not. But I remember that day when you ladies came to just pay me a visit, and I said, no, muimbe wano, muimbe bwemuti. And that recording is on that album. It is also a song that I concocted from another folk tale, Njabara. In the folk tale, Njabara, the girl there, if you notice when they sing Njabara, 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 Tori Nsanzo Muku, Mama Nakuba, Singa Nakuba, that means it was a girl child. Because it was girls who went to Senga to be groomed. And there's a lot to it, but I will just do it and hope most of you know it anyway.
Nyinamunganga genawa, o genawa kwe, nina kura binyo nina munganga, o jaga zachi yo chino nyako checho, nina kura binyo nina munganga. Nina kura binyo nina munganga, mama tokuba. Tata tonku banzi, nina kura banyo nina munganga. Singa tokuba, jaja tonyi ganzi, nina kura binyo nina munganga. Luachi bankuba, luachi bambu manzi, nina kura banyo nina munganga. Luachi bankuba, sinza yata muzinge, nina kura binyo nina munganga. Lwachi bankuba, lwachi bambumanze, nina kura banyo nina munganga. Lwachi bankuba, sinze yata muzinge, nina kura binyo nina munganga. Nina kura binyo nina munganga. Nina kura binyo nina munganga. Nina kura ba nina kura banze, nina kura binyo nina munganga, nina kura binyo nina munganga.
Thank you. Thank you very much. To get back to today, I am very sensitive to some things. One Christmas day, especially, it was during those times, I think, that a friend of mine, she lives in the UK, she came, she does that every year for the street people, and especially those Karamojong kids. So she invited me to go and play for their Christmas party in Mengom Chiseng. And I went, and I couldn't play. It just couldn't happen. That Christmas day, I went, locked myself in my house, and I wrote this song. Now, I've been asked many questions. What does the word ningi mean? It is my way of saying nini or what, or bachichi. I just coined that up, it just came to my head. And of course, you know what ngali is. So put one and two together and get five, yeah.
Answers, Ngali, please tell me. Ningi Ngali Ningi, who are these children? Where are they from? Is this their country? Where is their home? Ningi Ningi Ningi, Ningi Ngali Ningi, Ningi Ningi Ningi, Ningi Ngali Ningi, Ningi Ningi Ningi, Ningi Ngali Ningi. Ningi ningi ningi, ningi ngali ningi. Who are these people? Where are they from? Is this their country? Where is their home? Why are they homeless? Why are they hopeless? Why are you silent? ningi ngali ningi 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 ngali ningi. Why are they homeless? Why are they hopeless? Why are you silent? Ningi ngali ningi, ningi ningi ningi, 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 ningi ngali ningi, ningi ngali ningi, ningi ngali.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And I really, really, from the bottom of my heart, hope someone does something about those little kids. It is sad. Now, at this point is where we would have gone for a break. So I'm going to ask, can we have some lights, house? So I'm the next three songs, I just cannot replicate with one guitar. But I want to promise you that the next time I come out like this, it will be with a band and it will be complete. there's some songs I'd have loved to just play bass guitar because my main instrument is a bass guitar. So anyhow, we'll see. The first song is called Abantu Babi. Like some of the other songs, expresses something that I've seen in life. I write my songs from mine and other people's experience. But what is very pleasing for me with this song? And I'm going to ask this girl to please come up here. Sheila, will you come here, please? Sheila, please come. Okay, all right, yeah. I invited her. She sings better than me. She plays guitar. And her being here is breaking a bit of the rules because she's in the middle of exams. But being the dad I am, well, it's all good, yeah. Because I know she'll pass very well because she's as bright as I am. Yes. Well, when she's ready, she'll come up. She featured on this song. The female voice you hear in the chorus is her, and the recording is not on point. But let's listen to Abantu Babi now. Yeah.
I remember everything you said.